So, you know, I know that
that's how they roll.
This album is coming out now. And another artist that we just all found out was going to be releasing some new material, well, Nine Inch Nails, which you're very familiar with.
Yes.
Right? Guitar player for Nine Inch Nails early on. And then you're hearing, oh, well, there's going to be a big tour. And then it's like, oh, well, Filter's got a new album. And then, you know, if I was a gambling man, I might say something about maybe a Filter Nine Inch Nails kind of tour. Does that sound like something that would be in the works?
I would do that in a minute.
Yeah.
I would do that in a New
York. You definitely get a bus for that.
I would do that in a New York second.
We would have a bus for that.
I would love to do that. I would love to see that happen.
All right. So Trent Reznor, if you're watching right now.
That would be awesome. Like, maybe go up and play Head Like a Hole.
Yeah.
As Piggy, as the person I was back then, as the character I was back then. Yeah.
Hey, awesome. We'll start a campaign. I'm going to start a Twitter page right now.
You know, I'd be fully behind that, and I think it'd be good for everybody, and it'd be... You know, it was really cool. I went up to Trent's house and I played him the new record, and he, like, blew his speakers. He was like, "Jesus, right?" You know. Nice. So he's a good friend, and you know, without Trent, I don't know if I know I would have made it, but I don't know if it would have been as fun as it was. You know, I mean, back in Nine Inch Nails, we were crazy. We had no idea what we were doing. We were making up all the rules as we went along. I mean, we trashed, you know, hotel room after hotel room, you know, backstage after backstage. It was like, we were like, well, this isn't going to last. I mean, we were just like constantly fearing the worst. Like, well, we're never going to have this opportunity again, so let's just tackle each other on stage. Well, I'll never forget, we were in the D.C., you know, that place up in Washington, D.C., that little famous club. What is it? 930 Club, exactly. And he threw like a full beer at me because I made a mistake or something. And I looked at him. And I was like, "What?" And I threw like a bottle of beer back at him. And the crowd like went crazy. And we were like, "You like that?" And
yeah.
He threw another beer at each other. He threw a beer and then he tackled me. And then I tackled him. And it was just like that kind of stuff was just rampant. We were just like violent, crazy. Because I was definitely not like it was just I didn't see myself as anything other than a musician, and you know, we were, you know, at that age, you know, you graduate high school, and then all of a sudden, you've got a couple of years where you're just like realizing, like, holy cow, now what, you know? And you always
now somebody's gonna pay me to play guitar in a band on a tour bus, and
well, and even that started off as being like, you know, we're gonna get in a van, and we're just gonna see what happens, and we'll, you know, maybe we'll tour the U.S. for a couple weeks and see how it works out.
A couple weeks,
and then it turned out to be the, and it was awesome, and it was a great way to start my career. I had a blast. Trent and I would laugh and just, you know, it was just. I mean, Dance Party USA. Have you seen that video, Dance Party USA?
Yeah, I have.
We were in hysterics.
I think we posted it on our website right before you guys came up here, too.
Like when
you're welcome.
Whoever posted that kind of had the intent of, well, guess what I found? Like, this is, like, scandalous or something. We were absolutely drunk as hell. It was, like, 10 a.m. in the morning. We were laughing. We knew it was ridiculous. We thought it was hysterical. We were doing it just to get the experience of, like, doing it. It wasn't, like, a PR thing. It was just, like, I don't know. Someone says do it. We'll do we'll do anything at that point.
I can kind of see that song as a Dance Party USA song.
I mean, they were, like, here are all these little, like, mod, you know, like...
Right.
New wave kids, you know, like back in 1989, and then there's us. And we're on stage. I fell off the stage at one point.
It was seems to be a theme for Filter, people falling.
Falling. Yeah.
What's going on with that? No. Well, and so then, you know, fast forward quite a few years, and now you're back. You got a new album?
Yeah, we have this amazing new record. Johnny and I went into a studio with Bob Marlette, and we got signed to Wind Up, and it was a big deal to us.
Yeah.
We worked really hard on it, and Phil and Jeff are out on the road with us supporting this whole thing, and we hooked up with Summerland, and we're on that tour, and we're kind of, it's just a really exciting time for the band. You know, we have this new video coming out. It's really, like, it's really kind of controversial. It's like the kids, these down-and-out kids kind of take over a country club, and everything gets out of hand, and, you know, there's... We actually make a little cameo in it. It's like a little movie. It's pretty cool.
Cool. And, I know that a lot of times bands try to push the envelope with the videos to be a little controversial because then, I don't even know who plays videos anymore. Like MTV doesn't, but
well, YouTube does.
Yeah, exactly. So it's like you. I mean, but you don't get banned from YouTube. It used to be cool back in the day. Like, oh, our video was so controversial, it's banned. And YouTube's like the place to go to watch band videos.
Yeah, I mean, I've seen some pretty unbelievable stuff. But it's also creative freedom, finally. I mean, you know, MTV was like, well, we don't want any guns in the videos. So you're like, no guns. Okay, no guns. All right. You know, how can you kind of say what you want to say about society or bring something up? If
what do you want to say? Right?
What do you say? That's an amazing segue. You should take this opportunity.
You like that? All right, ladies and gentlemen, you guys can play a couple songs for us?